such a treat. Thank you very much. I was going to ask you a question myself. Where do you place Jayarasi Bhatta? Because you're one of the few people who has you've translated. This is a very important Charuvaka text. And sir is one of the few people who has even read it, I think, let alone translated. What is it? Tatvapla Upaplava Simha.
He is a skeptic.
So it's a deeply skeptical text.
Yes. Even that has been taken into consideration and refuted by the end. So nothing can be proved to be real. You prepare the categories of real, no? Reals, no? But first you have to prove that it is real.
So it's very deconstructive. That text is very deconstructive. That is the point.
So I translated that in 600 pages translation. So but before that, the Madhanikas have all them, but an attempt. But this man, rebirth and many other things, you know, the Buddha taking form in different life and different journey, they did not deny that. But here, anything which is beyond perception is not acceptable by Charvakas. And therefore he writes a book by the name Tattva, the truth, Upaplava Singha. When a lion enters into a, let us say, a beautiful rose garden, your Tattva truths are like rose. Then what will you do? Even destroy. So I am a Charvaka, he says, and you are all
roses.
I enter into the garden and I destroy everything. You cannot establish anything as real. Come on.
Sir, have your tea and we'll take a couple of questions. Yes, sir. You start.
Visha ki tarah bahut fascinating tha sir. Ek sawal mein do teen sawal hai chote chote. Ek sawal mera ye tha ki ye jo discussion hai khyati ko leke, ये क्या शंकर और अद्वैत के बाद शुरू हुआ है या उससे पहले?
उससे पहले
क्योंकि शंकर के आने से
इसका जो बाद में है उससे बहुत पहले ये भाष्य जो कहा ना आपको मैं भाष्य उसके पहले मीमांसा में है
वहाँ ख्याति को लेकर डिस्कशन है। दूसरा सवाल ये था कि ये जो इतनी सारी टर्म्स हैं अगर इनको डिफाइन किया गया है तो फिर इनके बीच में इंटर रिलेशंस को भी डिस्कस किया गया है
जरूर क्या जब रिफ्यूट किया गया है तो
बुद्धों उसकी चर्चा कम मिलती है इंटर रिलेशनशिप जो है
मैं आपको खासकर न्याय मंजरी पढ़िए आपको पता चलेगा कि किस तरह की एनालिसिस रखी है उन्होंने रिफ्यूट करने के लिए भी बहुत एनालाइज करना पड़ता है आपको पहले अच्छी तरह समझना पड़ता है कि आप क्या कहना चाहते हैं इसलिए द ओपोनेंट्स व्यू हैज टू बी एनालाइज्ड थॉरली हमारे जो गुरुजी थे वो कहते थे कि अगर ओपोनेंट को तुम्हें उत्तर देना है तो वो क्या कहता है उसको रिपीट करो और जैसे खूंटा है ना ये खंबा तो उसको हिलाते रहो और इतना हिला लो कि अंत में ऐसे
एक लास्ट सिर्फ वो थी डाउट को लेकर जो संदेह है हम जब आधुनिक पश्चिमी दर्शन को देखते हैं तो संदेह का उसमें इतना मतलब वो एक महत्वपूर्ण कारक के रूप में उभरता है डिकार्ट से लेके हमारे यहाँ भारतीय दर्शन में संदेह को सीधे हम जो है उसको मतलब अज्ञान के निकट ही देखते हैं ज्ञान के जनक के रूप में संदेह को देखते हैं
क्या है कि यू आर प्रोवोकिंग मी फॉर अनदर लेक्चर
दी जैसे संशय आत्मा विनक्षति उस तरह श्रद्धावान
सही बात सही ढंग से सही
इसको हम इसको मैं इस बहस में देखना चाहता हूँ अधूरा ज्ञान
देखिए और गलत ज्ञान we do not discuss without a definition
sir chai bhi liye
we do not discuss to be bold so what is samshaya let us discuss what is doubt in doubt विरुद्ध धर्मावगाही ज्ञान एकस्मिन् धर्मिनि द धर्म द लोकस इज वन एंड थ्रू mutually contradicting properties and appearing before me. Is it a post or a man? Now post has postness and man has manness. But the locus is one and the same. So in one and the same locus, when two contradictory properties you find, it is called doubt. Viruddha. So viruddha, the two are contradicting each other. And they are appearing in one and the same locus. So once this definition is before you, now you have to ask question. You ask question. That with this samsaya is required or not. This samsaya is required because the category, nayayakas will say, because there is a false cognition category also. But Prabhakara said that it is not necessary. So the logicians have totally refuted Prabhakara on this basis. Then where is the problem? The problem is called Veda Agra. The remembrance of the silver and perception of the Shukti, not as Shukti. Between these two, there is a difference. That difference he could not catch. And that is why he said this is silver.
So, but sir, do you accept that in our tradition, doubt is not a source of knowledge as much as in the Western tradition, especially after enlightenment, where everything should be
doubt? I do not agree.
You do not agree?
I do not agree, because unless there is, see, sandehat nyaya pravartate, samshayat nyaya pravartate, na siddhe arthe nyaya pravartate. So when something is already known, there is no doubt, the discussion cannot take place. So the very root or the requirement of a discussion is doubt.
And yet, as you said, the two astik nastik, you know, went towards establishing either the supremacy or the authority or the validity of the Vedas on the one hand or otherwise. So we are, it seems to me, just to go on his side a little bit, we are somehow a very, should I say, pious, or we do worship our tradition and text. So even when we question them, it's not as radical as in the modern West, where you can be totally anti-foundationalist, or you disagree with that. You don't. Okay, good. Let's take some more. Yeah. But to speak on the other side, the entire Gita is born out of doubt. Because he doesn't know what to do.
Yeah.
Dilemma. So it's a, you may call it a dharma sankata as well. So I think that there is room for doubt. And yet, I think
Gautama in the first sutra, one padartha is samshaya.
Okay.
So just given a category is requirement for philosophy. You can't do philosophy without that.
Without doubt. No samshaya.
And therefore, the Daya Krishna for several years, he was asking me, he was telling me that, "Arey, aap log kya nyay karte hain? Samshay ko aapne baad mein rakh diya. Pramana, prameya, samshay baad mein aapne kyun rakha? Pehle rakhna chahiye tha samshaya, pramana." Maine kaha ki aap mere paas aaye, main aapko padha dunga ki kyun rakha. So pata chalega. It is not that the samshay is not. Samshay is very much required. Without that, na nyaya pravartate. No discourse is possible. No anumana is possible.
Yeah, after you, yeah. I just heard.
Yeah. He has been waiting for such a long time. Sorry.
It's really like, if we had such a rigorous method of analyzing truth and reality, which you know compares with the best systems of knowledge developed anywhere in the world, even more advanced than that, and why could we not develop a scientific tradition which would have kind of followed logically from this kind of system of building knowledge? Ultimately,
I could not read that.
Why did modern science come up in the West?
Oh.
why did we use this rigorous methodology to produce natural science the way West did?
I think the answer is very difficult for me, but the looking of any discourse, anything that we do, has to be holistic in character. It must take into account the purpose of life. So what is the purpose of life? You can't come and I don't want to discuss that. Then all that can happen. That has happened in the West. But if you bring the purpose of life also in the domain of discourse, then perhaps you get the answer that why that much emphasis was not given to that. Two goals of life have been projected. One is called Abhyudaya. Abhyudaya. Development. Okay. Development. Abhyudaya. But is there upper limit of Abhyudaya? After reaching that, you say, no, I don't want hereafter any. This has also been discussed. And therefore we need to posit. So that's not the purpose of life. Because that will not get. So what is the purpose of life? I must be back to myself, what I am. And that is not possible if I go on multiplying Abhyudaya. And therefore the second term is Nishreyasa. I think this discourse was brought even into the scientific discourse of the tradition. So they developed all niceties and analyzing thoughts. But ultimately, what for? What for should I do that? That may be one of the reasons.
So let's move on. There are Professor Pradhana.
Why does Sankara or Advaitins call their Khyatibad Adivachana Khyati? Because what they call the error is both Sat and Asat.
If you ask me frankly, my answer is they have accepted degrees in reality.
Because they call it Sat Asat. Yeah.
So neither Sat nor Asat.
In the case of snake rope illusion.
And when this also is going to vanish, when? Only when you have Brahma Gyana.
So it is that Adivachanya because it cannot be expressed in language?
Yes. No, not expressed in language.
Because Adivachanya means?
It cannot be categorized in the category of Sat.
Yes.
It cannot be categorized in the category of Asat.
Okay, thank you.
It is neither fictitious nor it is real. So a third category. But suppose those who do not accept Shankara, he does not need this category at all. That is why I say that any philosophical system has to be built in terms of the world views of that system.
See, this Andhivachani is very interesting. In Chaitanya's Gaudiya, what is the relation between the Atma and the Paramatma? It is Achintya Veda. It's not separate. You're not separate from the divine, and you can't. So these are very interesting ways to dodge the limitation of language, which is based on subject-object dualism. But in that state of Brahmajnana, there is no subject-object dualism, and so to make these categories becomes very difficult. But sir, I thought what you just said was very profound. That in Shankara, Advaita, there is degrees of reality.
The world is categorized as anekavachaniya.
So Brahman is Maya. is a reality which is the basis, the ground of reality. The world is not unreal, but is less real than Brahman. So when he says Jagan Mithya, the next one is say Prabha Satya Jagan Mithya. The next
Jivo Brahma hi bana.
Then there you are. So there is
so only that only consciousness part, you know. Not that position of consciousness, but the consciousness itself
is real.
Next.
So even I think in the Vedas, niyate iti maya, so that which is measurable. So that, but that cannot be ultimately true because the ultimate is immeasurable, etc., etc.
So a snake in the bush.
A barren woman.
A snake in the bush. A snake in dream. And a snake in rope. What is the reality? One is Pratibhasika. Paramarthika. Brahman is Paramarthika. Ultimate real. Make believe real. So, Vyavaharika Satta. Paramarthika Satta. And Pratibhasika. So, as long as that illusion continues, the snake exists.
Yes.
Otherwise, it will not run. For you, it exists. So you accept existence of that snake. So these degrees of reality, Shankara created. And this is how he explained them. So whole universe is therefore, duality is nothing but anirvachani.
Thank you. Yes, sir, go ahead.
You can hear me, I'm sure. What appears to be probably a very elaborate taxonomy of miscognition and the process of miscognition. I was just wondering whether these conceptions have actually influenced the practices of pedagogy. And I'll tell you why, because there is an understanding that probably the Khandanvaya method is influenced by, say, the Mimamsakas, their system of taking the verb as the figurehead of the sentence itself, and asking questions, the dialogue pattern. So I was wondering whether this is
true. I mean, correct. So what is happening is you identify the focus.
I'm not able to follow.
Yeah, what is the method you mentioned?
Khandanvaya.
Khandanvaya.
No, part by part.
Part by part.
And as a whole. Now you see, Mimamsakas, the entire meaning of the Veda becomes what? Only action. Kriya. And all others sentences have to be brought in relation to that. Dandanvaya. The entire bulk of Vedic literature, because his idea is to justify that a person must take up an ethical activity. The activity should be ethical one, sanctioned one. No, I'm purposefully putting it in modern terminology. Sanctioned means what? Sanctioned by the constitution becomes ethical or not? If a constitution sanctions something, is it ethical? Of course it will say the ethical, it will go to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court will say, no, this is sanctioned by the constitution. It has to be ethical. In that way, if Veda is taken as that kind of a text, which sanctions an activity, therefore the Bhashya of Jaimini Bhashya, the Savara Bhashya, Veda is your friend. Suhid Upadesha. The term that we use is an advice of your friend. And friend, if a real friend will never want anything bad for you. So Veda is telling you to do something, this he's a friend telling you to do something which is good for you, good for your life. Take it that way. And therefore induce a person to ethical activity, moral activity. So artha and anartha. So kriya, some kriya is artha and the other kriya is anartha. So killing, for example, is anartha. But giving is, sharing is artha. This kind of discussions have happened. So dandanvaya and khandanvaya, it all related to the focus of your discourse. What you want to achieve through this discourse? You were very much aware of the social needs. Even so, those who think that the tradition has nothing to do with the social needs, they are all wrong. They have not gone to the tradition. Nothing happens unless it is tallied with the life of human being. Any discourse. This is the way gets discussed. I hope I have addressed
I was also wondering whether the other schools have had some impact in the pedagogical systems in some other way.
Of course. There has been give and take. There has, for example, I told you that God was there in one system, was not there in one system. In course of time, they thought that it should be incorporated. Even the logicians, the Nayayikas have God, but the Vaisheshika did not have God. But later on, it became, by 10th century, you find, Jayanta is writing, Vaisheshika hatu asmat anuyayina, they are all followers. So they have been give and take all. So each system has contributed, some developed tools, some developed ideas, and those ideas were made use by one and all. This has been the tradition. So a synthetic approach, as you say, at philosophical level, I do find there is a synthetic approach. But not going for the physical development, this seems to be because our mind is trained in such a way to see everything in terms of life, and that has to be holistic. So value cannot be sacrificed, and it is two tier value, the physical achievement and the fulfillment, a sense of fulfillment. So we wanted fulfillment to be the ultimate goal of human life, and that is why perhaps, I don't know, this may be the reason.
Because in the theory of serialism, there are the illusions, it's obvious, it's a highlighted or depicted as a part of the...
Can all of them be put into these two categories? Sadhisthana Brahma and Niradhisthana Brahma.
I'm not entirely sure. I have to think about it.
Then give me an example, I will think again.
Yes. No, because, I can use Sialdwar there by saying that yes and no to your question.
Now, X can be known as Y, and even without X, I can have Y.
See, because when you say, we have to talk a little more about it, because, when you started with a binary, which contradicts the plural scheme that you came up with by saying it is either true or not true.
And the third category was
so that all these surrealism
but
and all they were
for that you have to see the reply of
the logicians.
Yeah.
So my point is these people were for the first time coming up with, unconscious. What is the unconscious? And the images that come from that. Are they entirely real? Are they not real? Are they unreal? They're not quite hallucinations either. There's something else there.
The Nyaya position is that whatsoever fictitious it may be,
yes,
it is a construction of the given.
And therefore?
So that should be put under the category of nothing but an illusion created out of the given. Okay. So the given and the creative. I need only two categories, two boxes.
Creative money,
even mentally creative.
Okay, but that's an illusion.
No.
But what is reality? Very complicated. What is reality? But this mess, what is the mess of reality? See? Because the Buddhists say there's no mess, there's no isness, there's no substance.
No, you only quote the Buddhists as saying, but you do not know what reply has been given as that.
Yeah, sir.
So you should also see what
I should say with you more often. Anita ji, yes.
Thank you so much for your lecture. So this is a kind of a hyper-textual question, so to say. You started your lecture, and in fact your entire lecture was flanked by two questions. The value of Indian tradition, and again you asked at the end, you said that where do we need to kind of bring in this. So where do you see this isn't it always already valued? And if not, as you assumed, because you flanked your entire lecture by two concerns, So where do you see that, you know, how do you place it in the entire, whether it is in pedagogy or in education? So what is your idea about, you know, the Indian tradition, and how do you see it being...
If this analysis, the method of analysis is adopted, and the plan of life, goal of life, two-tier goal of life is put, then I'll be able to identify the goals through the method of analysis that we have developed. And not only we, any human being can arrive at that kind of position.
I've been thinking, because I thought this is a very silly question, but then I just need to clarify something. When we talk of cognition, are we basing our cognition on empirical perceptions? Like, for example, like I know this is a pen because my senses perceive this to be a pen,
yeah.
Right? So all my five senses of touch and
yeah.
See and smell or whatever makes me perceive this as a pen.
Mm-hmm.
But a false cognition, does it therefore mean that one of my senses is not active? Or is it, I don't know, I mean, how do I see that?
Okay.
Yeah, because see, if I...
You will understand it more and more
yeah.
if you concentrate on a section called Pramana.
Pramana is a proof.
Don't come to the conclusion.
Okay.
Pramana is the process of knowing.
Mm-hmm.
So there is one process called direct process of knowing.
Mm-hmm.
I call it directly internalizing the universe. And we human beings are programmed in that way. We have been provided five sense organs externally.
Mm-hmm.
And to relate the knower with the data, a sixth sense organ called mind. So, Atman, Manas, Indriya. You understand no? These
mm-hmm.
terms? So, the knower, the self, the mind, the sense organ, and the world, this is the process. When this process is there, then this is directly the knower is internalizing the world. Internalizing is what? Making the content of his cognition.
Mm-hmm.
This is one thing. But is it that everything we know directly, is it true? We do not know directly everything.
But for me it is the truth, isn't it? Or is it an illusion?
No.
But for me it will be the truth, right?
What you are. So let us say you see this.
Mm-hmm.
So this is true or not?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
For
true.
Me it is a truth. That's what I'm saying. But I mean, for different perceptions it might be.
No, but this is now it I present here, how many people are there? Is it a Bisleri bottle or not? Is it public or private?
But sir,
I mean, no, I mean just wait.
Yeah.
But I am happy.
What is the color of the bottle? Yeah, that you
color blindness will come again.
But all agreed that this is the bottle.
Yeah.
And when I ask you to bring this bottle, you bring the same bottle. Is it true or false? Is it for me or for all? So, training is necessary for this analysis.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So there is a direct process of knowing called pratyaksha pramana. And there are indirect process of knowing in which there is inference, language, analogy, presumption, and n number of things. And all these are reduced by logician to only four. Four will include all that you can imagine. Do you want to get trained in this or not?
Yes.
Yeah.
Or keep on doing blah blah?
No.
This is what's to be done. You wanted the answer? Pedagogical importance is this. Once you introduce this in education, then each one is empowered to analyze.